I welcome you all to my YouTube channel Insight into Chemical Engineering. In this lecture series, we will solve the unsolved problem of a famous book, that is Stoichiometry and Process Calculations by Kevin Arrhenius. These lectures are helpful for chemical engineering students because process calculations is a core subject for chemical engineering branch. During lecture, step-by-step solution will be provided. And in this lecture, exercise number 4.23 to 4.26 will be covered. Please like and subscribe for motivation. Problem number 4.23, in the manufacture of formaldehyde by Monsanto process, air, methyl alcohol and steam are used in the ratio 4:2:1 by weight at 800 kilopascal and 380 Kelvin, we need to estimate the partial pressure of the individual gases. For finding out the partial pressure, we can use Dalton's law. Using Dalton's law, partial pressure can be estimated because in general we can write partial pressure of any gas divided by total pressure will be equal to mole fraction of that gas. So we need to estimate the moles of air, methyl alcohol and steam. So as per problem, weight ratio of individual gases are given and we don't know what was the multiplication factor so that we can get the initial values in weight. So we can assume, suppose X was the multiplication factor, and we can rewrite the weight ratio by multiplying with X. Now we can say that 4X is the weight of air and 2X is the weight of CH3OH and 1X is the weight of steam. Now we have written the weight of individual components. Now we can estimate the number of moles of individual components. Number of moles can be written as weight divided by its molecular weight. So weight of air is 4x and its molecular weight is 29. In the same way, we can estimate the number of moles of methyl alcohol and steam. Now we can easily use the Dalton's law. And as per Dalton's law, partial pressure of air divided by total pressure will be equal to moles of air divided by total moles. Now 4x by 29 is the moles of air, and total mole can be estimated by summing the moles of air plus methyl alcohol plus steam. Now after simplification, we will get 0.138x divided by 0.257x. Now this x will get cancelled and value of P total is known, so we can easily estimate the partial pressure of air. So partial pressure of air will be equal to 0.138 divided by 0.257 into 800 kilopascal, and it will come out as 4.296 × 10⁵ Newton per meter square. Now using the same formula and same procedure, we can estimate the partial pressure of methyl alcohol and partial pressure of steam. Problem number 4.24, what is the average molecular weight of a flue gas having the following composition by volume? So we need to estimate the average molecular weight of a gas mixture. So first we will write the formula for average molecular weight. So we know the number of moles can be written as weight divided by molecular weight for any gas. Now on rearranging, we can write molecular weight equal to weight divided by number of moles. So this is the formula for a single gas. Now if we have a mixture of gases, then we can rewrite the average molecular weight will be equal to total weight divided by total moles. So we need to estimate the total weight and total moles. And for gases, volume percentage and mole percentage are same. So we can assume total moles of flue gas equal to 100 mole. Now we can write moles of CO2 will be equal to 13 and moles of CO will be equal to 3, moles of O2 will be equal to 4 and moles of N2 will be equal to 80. Now we can write the moles of individual gases and we can write the weight of CO2. So weight of CO2 will be equal to moles of CO2, that is 13, into its molecular weight, and it will be equal to 572 gram. In the same way, weight of CO and weight of N2 can be estimated. So weight of CO will be equal to moles of CO into its molecular weight. In the same way, we can write weight of O2 will come out as 128 and weight of N2 will come out as 2240 gram. Now we can estimate the total weight of flue gases. So simply add the weight of all individual gas components and it will come out as 3024 gram. And we have already assumed the total moles of flue gas equal to 100 mole. Now we can easily estimate the average molecular weight. So average molecular weight will come out as 30.24 gram per mole. Problem number 4.25, assuming that air contains 78.1% nitrogen, 21% oxygen and rest is argon. Estimate the average molecular weight and density of air at particular temperature and pressure. So again, for estimating the average molecular weight, first we need to estimate the total weight and the total moles. So we can assume total moles of air equal to 100. Now we can write moles of nitrogen will be equal to 78.1 and moles of oxygen will be equal to 21 and moles of argon will be equal to 0.9. Now after writing the moles of individual component, we can estimate their weight. For that, molecular weight is required. So molecular weight of N2 is 28, molecular weight of O2 is 32 and molecular weight of argon is 40. We can write weight of N2 equal to moles of N2 into its molecular weight. In the same way, we can estimate the weight of oxygen, weight of argon. Now in order to estimate the total weight, we can add all weight. So total weight of air will come out as 2.894 kg. We can write the formula for average molecular weight. It will be equal to total weight by total moles. So this is the total weight and 100 is the total moles that we have assumed. So average molecular weight will come out as 28.95 gram per mole. So in next part, we need to estimate the density of air. We know density equal to mass per unit volume. So mass we have already estimated. Now we need to estimate the volume. And already temperature and pressure conditions are given. So we can use the ideal gas law, and according to this V will be equal to nRT by P. Now we can put the all values and volume will come out as 2.45 meter cube. Now density can be estimated easily and it will come out as 1.1812 kg per meter cube. Problem number 4.26. A natural gas has the following composition by volume. So again composition is given by volume percentage, and we know for gases volume percentage and mole percentage are same. So calculate part A, composition in weight percentage. So first we need to estimate the weight of individual components, then we can estimate the composition in weight percentage. So we are assuming the total moles of natural gas equal to 100 mole. After assuming this, we can write the moles of CO2 will be equal to 0.8, moles of N2 will be equal to 3.2, and moles of CH4 will be equal to 96. Now we can estimate the weight of individual component. So weight of CO2 will be equal to moles of CO2 into its molecular weight. So in the same way, weight of N2 and CH4 can be estimated. Now we can write the total weight. For total weight, add up the all weight of individual component and it will come out as 1.66 kg. Now we can estimate the part A. We can write the weight percentage of CO2 will be equal to weight of CO2 divided by total weight into 100, and weight of CO2 is 35.2 and total weight is 1660.8 gram. So weight percentage will come out as 2.12%. In the same way, weight percentage of N2 can be estimated and weight percentage of CH4 can also be estimated. Now in part B, we need to estimate the average molecular weight, and in order to estimate average molecular weight, total weight and total moles should be known. We have already estimated the total weight and we have assumed total moles equal to 100 mole. So we can easily estimate the average molecular weight and it will come out as 16.61 gram per mole. Now in part C, we need to estimate the density at standard conditions. We know density equal to mass per unit volume. So mass we have already estimated, only we need to estimate the volume at standard conditions. We know that 1 mole of gas occupies 22.4 liter at STP conditions, and we have assumed total moles are 100 moles. So 100 moles will occupy 22.4 into 100 at STP conditions. So we need to convert this liter to meter cube and then we can find out the density. So total weight divided by volume, and density will come out as 0.74 kg per meter cube.